up, guys? Brave Leonard here, and welcome to episode number 17 of our Pokemon White Randomizer Nuzlocke Challenge. Today we are starting out just having this staring contest with this Team Plasma goon over here. that's where we're starting out from. Here in the middle of Charged Stone Cave. If you missed the last episode, then please do go and check it out. We made it halfway through Charged Stone Cave and then realized that we were kind of running out of time and there was still a couple of members of Team Plasma left and like the upstairs to do as well. So I didn't really know what was going on, so I just stopped in the middle of Charged Stone Cave. But if you're excited for this episode of the Pokemon White Randomizer Nuzlocke, then please do leave a like, comment, and subscription down below. You know that I appreciate all of your interaction. With that, we're going to do a team recap. We have got Raticate here. Scabbers the Raticate, level 30. Currently holding the Shell Bell with Smelling Salt, Bullet Seed, Crunch, and Cut. Leviathan, level 30. Gyarados with Thrash, Bullet Seed, Strength, and Bite, holding the Amulet Coin. We've got Martha, level 30. Vullaby with Fly, Gust, Faint Attack, and Nasty Plot, holding the Eviolite. Polarity, level 30. Magnezone with Thundershock, Psybeam, Thunder Wave, and Supersonic, holding the Magnet. Gaia, the level 29. Torterra with Strength, Psybeam, Bullet Seed, and Bite, holding the Rocky Helmet. And finally, Faith, level 30 Mashana, our starter, with Psybeam, Lucky Chant, Defense Curl, and Hypnosis. The same moveset that she's had since episode 1. And currently holding the Quick Claw because Faith is really slow. Really slow. We're going to put Gaia out front because Gaia is the only one that is not level 30. So, Oh. Hello. We've got people to beat. And, I've no idea what else we're supposed to be doing in this episode, but we're just going to continue fighting. I'll explore downstairs, because I think we're supposed to go upstairs. That might be wrong, though. No, I don't know. But we'll quickly run through these trainers. Everything is going swimmingly in the White Randomized Nuzlocke right now. We're doing well. Zero deaths so far. Now that I've said that, we're definitely going to have a death this episode. But, zero deaths so far. And everything seeming to be going well. Which is concerning. Both concerning from a standpoint of what if everything starts going wrong? And concerning from the standpoint of, I worry about what you guys are thinking about this series right now. You know, we get 17 episodes in, and there's still nothing really happening. I think we have to Psybeam this Torkoal. No, I did nothing, and I'm trapped in now. That did nothing, and I'm trapped in now. Right, what about if I use strength then? Nothing does anything. We definitely got Psybeam now. His defense is going to go even higher. I'd really like for this Torkoal to like body slam me and get some Rocky Helmet damage. Smokescreen. I don't really know what I can do to... this might sound strange. I don't know what I can do to encourage deaths. Like, it's just not happening. So, I don't know how I can make it more interesting for you guys. Like, in the future, now that I know how we're doing here, I can put the difficulty up. But I can't do that now in the middle of a playthrough. So... I feel like we do actually need to heal. Don't do too much. Okay. And we're freed from Fire Spin. So that means we can switch. Which I need to switch because I'm so low in my... whatchamacallit. Accuracy. That I just can't land a move. See, even then... Great, smoke screen again. Even then, I didn't heal spam. I tried not to, anyway. It's quite difficult to not have heal spam there. Level 31 for Scabbers. Our officially strongest mon that we've got. We've got a Shallows coming in here. Yeah, we'll go into Leviathan. We'll heal outside of battle. Like I say, I'm trying to make sure that it makes it a little bit harder. Obviously, there are a few things. I could try and ban items from in battle, which is obviously a self-imposed clause, which makes things a little bit more difficult. I can increase the difficulty in the randomizer. All these have to come in future playthroughs, though. So. And I guess I could put the battle style to set as well. So another way you can make it harder for yourself. Okay. Or I can do completely different Nuzlocke variants. I can also do that, like obviously the retirement lot that I did was that little bit harder because it had a lot more rules and it was set battle style and stuff like that. And I didn't get to choose my team in the slightest. But yeah, it's just I'm not taking on this Blaziken. Because if he blaze kicks me, which he probably does have, Gaia is going down. So we'll go straight into Leviathan, get that Intimidate drop off. Look at him, he's so intimidating. And he packs. Feel like Thrash is going to kill. It does with a crit. I don't know if that crit mattered. A Terrakion! Right, so Terrakion is rock fighting. So I can't stay in. So I have to go into Gaia. Well, it's either Gaia or Faith. But Gaia seems to be the most sensible option here. High defense. Feel like Terrakion probably has. Well, takedown. Takedown will do as well. But I was going to say double kick. And it would take two lots of Rocky Helmet damage. That is a bulky Terrakion. Let me know what you think about the difficulty and what your thoughts are in the about the fact that we've not really lost any mons or anything like that. What can I do? What can I do? I can't really impose anything on this. Basically, right now, my goal is kind of I want to beat this game without losing a mon now. That's my goal. And it's not going to happen. But I really do want to beat this game without losing a mon. That's now my challenge in my head. But obviously, like, you guys aren't going to find that as good a content. And I understand that. So, let me know what you think. Alright, oh, you're meeting Daddy here, aren't you? You are meeting Daddy. You strength. I just point out that I wasn't paying attention to strength's animation. And that is, like, the weirdest animation for strength since you used to throw a rock at them. It's cursing up. He's cursing up in front of Daddy. Oh, this is neutral. And he's got two curses up. Making that a little scary. Ordinal, who wants experience? Who do we want to get some experience? We want Martha to get some experience, don't we? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Because Martha needs all the experience that she can get. Because I really want to get a Mandibuzz. Entrainment. What does entrainment actually do? Okay, that did some decent damage. And I do absolutely nothing. So I'm going to nasty plot up. And try and kill it that way. I don't really think that I have much. Choice but to. What's entrainment do? I've just acquired Regenerator. Okay, I just acquired Regenerator. I want Martha to get this experience, so I am gonna heal in this one. See, I'm not enforcing the rules yet of that sort of stuff. Let's nasty plot up. We'll speed up as well, because, like, you don't need to see me nasty plotting everywhere. Plotting my nasties. Ordino, die. And it didn't. We'll do this down. Ooh, 3,200 experience. I got to level 32 with that. Oh no, nearly. Might as well stay in for this Iggly buff. One gust should kill it. Yeah. Okay. I'm exploring in that here, but berry juice. I feel like that's supposed to be a TM or something, and I've kind of just had that randomized to a berry juice, and that sucks. It's just in. It seems to be in a TM spot, if you know what I mean. Super Repel. Use. Alright. So now we can go upstairs and finish off the Team Plasma portion of the cave, I guess. Who do we want out? Oh, we've not seen Polarity for a little while. Let's go out with Polarity. Oh, hello, Anne. Many different values mixed together, and the world becomes grey. That is unforgivable. I will separate Pokemon and people, and black and white will be clearly distinct. Only then will Pokemon become perfect beings. Yes, that is my dream. That is the dream I must fulfill. Leon, do you have a dream of your own?
Yeah, sure.
You have a dream. That's wonderful. I'll learn just what kind of dream you have in battle.
Alright, we've got to take on N here. And N is only mildly terrifying. He's got four mons. Leads with a Beautifly, so not too worrying to start with. Especially because we've got Polarity out here. Our Thundershock is going to be our best move. And we just one-shot. Okay. Okay, Polarity, you calm down. No, don't calm down. Murder everything. Arbok, Polarity, you could stay in. You could stay in and Psybeam this Arbok. He's gonna, yeah, guess the defense increases from stockpile. Fair enough. That kept him alive. That kept him alive. What's the point of using Stockpile, though, if you're not going to use Spit Up or Swallow? Just kind of makes no sense to me. Vanillux. We have Flash Cannon. I'd like Flash Cannon. What do we use to take on a Vanilluxe? Sure, we'll go into Faith. More that Vanilluxe can't really do anything to Faith. Can't really do anything to most of my team, to be honest, but... That's a lot of... sorry, that was a lot of defense. And that's a lot of damage. Okay, Avalanche is physical. So I'm going to go out into Leviathan. We don't have anything for ice types. We don't have anything on the squad for ice types. No Mons or even attacks. We've got no rock type attacks or anything like that. Taunt's fine. I'm not using anything that's that taunt affects. Okay. Is that Steel type move, Mirror Shot? I feel like it is. Not something you see very often. Ambipom. Sure, we'll go back into Faith. I'm expecting a fake out, if they've got it. Because, oh no, N should have good AI, so. Can we kill, please? I didn't want to heal, but... He killed by one, then. Oh, we got the quick claw pop this time. So you can't rely on Quick Claw, but there it is. It's a thing. My friend's getting hurt. That's what a Pokemon battle is. Yeah, it is. Why? Is it impossible for me to win while feeling bad about being a trainer? As if I could pursue the truth with something as meaningless as a battle. As if that could make me worthy to become friends of the legendary Pokemon. Leon! Oh, here we go. Just a little farther to Miss Jolton City. Bianca, you have good ears. I can't believe you heard Leon's voice from that far away. Neither can I, seeing as I haven't spoken in years. Leon, who is this trainer? Professor Juniper. What are you thinking? You appear to have no qualms about the relationship between Pokemon and people. You put Pokemon into categories, using arbitrary rules, and think you can understand them like that. The very idea of a Pokedex revolts me. What do you have to say for yourself? Oh my, looks like you're not my biggest fan. Your opinion is understandable. It happens to be different from mine, which is equally understandable. How about if all people get to decide for themselves how to relate to Pokemon? You're saying I should just allow people to think whatever they want? And treat Pokemon however they want? No matter whether the Pokemon suffer? I refuse to tolerate the existence of a world like that. Oh dear. N's having a bit of an existential... I can't say that word. Existential? Crisis. He's having a bit of a crisis.
Well, I didn't expect him to change his mind right away, but I hope he'll spend a little time trying to understand how others feel. Now then, I think I'll go collect a little more data. For Pokemon and people to get along better, we need to take steps to learn more about them.
Leon, I'm going to go with Professor Juniper now, because I'm her bodyguard. You literally needed a bodyguard yourself a couple of episodes ago. Why would Professor Juniper trust you? Why? It makes no sense. Right, we made it here to Miss Drelton City anyway. Which is good. I'm happy with that. Because we still not got any rods. Where do you get the rod from? I don't want to know about my hidden power moves. What can I buy? I could buy a lot. But if I'm honest, I've got quite a lot, so I'm okay. There may be some TMs. I'd like some TMs, please. Yes! Crunch, Mud Bomb, Dragon Breath, and Shadow Ball. Oh, but what are the... They are some good TMs. Shadow Ball. I'll need Shadow Ball. TM 37. Isn't that Fire Blast? Am I going to need to know Fire Blast? Leviathan and Gaia can learn Shadow Ball. Neither of which is any good because it is a special attack in this game. I got excited because like Shadow Ball in 3rd gen and below would on a Gyarados would be amazing. Skylar is our gym leader in this city. Family's very fussy about Pokemon moves. The Reminder Girl. I don't have a heart scale, I don't think. Move deleter, I guess? Yeah. And... Nope. I'm good. I'm good. I like the music in this place. Oh, hello!
Oh, hey! Leon, right? Let me see your Pokedex for a moment. What do we have here? So you found 217 Pokemon, eh? Ha, staggering, you see the clink. You're becoming quite the trainer. Excuse me, eh? I was a little excited and forgot my manners. My name's Juniper too, Cedric Juniper. Ha, professor who gave you the Pokedex is my daughter. Ah, that girl has told me a lot about you. Really makes my day to meet you. In honor of our meeting, I'm going to upgrade your Pokedex because I'm better than my daughter. Ha. Some Pokemon can change forms, even when it's the same individual. If you've already seen a form, you can check it with this whenever you want. I also added a function to make searching easier.
I bet this is Skylar, isn't it? Hang on. I don't know, I feel like she's quite feminine. But I feel like she's quite underspoken as well, so she's kind of like,
Professor! Who's that trainer?
Oh, I forgot my introductions. Skylar, this is a friend of my daughter's. Leon is traveling around the universe to complete the Pokedex.
Oh, I see. That means you'll be challenging the gym. Oh boy, I'm really looking forward to it. Oh boy!
Intended to Mickey Mouse a little bit there.
That's right, Leon. You should challenge this gym. If nothing else, this gym is really out there. See you, Skylar. If something comes up again, I'll let you know.
Professor, my plane is a cargo plane. It carries cargo, not people. And you're talking as if places like Kanto and Sunnoh are right around the corner.
Ah, Skylar, if you keep frowning, your face might freeze like that. That'd be a shame. People and Pokemon have to help each other out. See you later.
Just kind of wonder what they were doing, you know.
Sheesh, it's hard to believe that a happy-go-lucky guy like that could be a world-renowned Pokemon professor. Huh, heads up, Leon. As a gym leader, I'd be happy to have you challenge the gym, but it's something I need to take care of first. Just now, as I was flying the cargo plane, I saw something on top of Celestial Tower. I'm sure that it's a sick Pokemon. If it is, I can't just leave it there. I have to go look into this right away. I'm leaving for Route 7 Celestial Tower. You can come along if you want.
I guess I will. We've got 5 minutes left in this episode with which to explore the rest of this. The rest of this area. Oh, you're not a trainer. I thought you might be a trainer. I saw this item and I want it. Clamp! Beautiful. Just what we needed was Clamp. Just what we needed. Oh, hello. Is this a berry farm or something? I don't know. It's not a berry farm. It's a farm. It ain't a berry farm. It ain't Ferrari, is this? Ain't no sixth gen. Is there any other items around here? Oh, hello. Oh, that's where... Well, of course that's where the gem is. Well, let's go there. Did I actually go in here? No. Help me! I don't want you to tell me anything, if I'm honest. I don't need your help! Is that it? That's all Mistralton City's got to offer. Well, in that case, Route 7 is a new encounter. So let's see what we can get. A Mime Jr. And it's just at this moment that I've remembered that I've been asked to name a Pokemon. I didn't do it in the last episode. You didn't remind me. You didn't shout at me reminding me when I caught the Pokemon in Chargestone Cave to nickname it after a certain... after a sub. So, I feel like Mime Jr. is probably not the Pokemon to name after a sub, to be honest. It's not the best mod in the world, and it pretty much definitely will not get used. So, I'd like a Pokemon that I will use at some point. Or I may use at some point. So, Mime Jr. is not that mod. What do we call a Mime Jr. then? It is a male Mime Jr. It's never getting out of this Mime Jr. phase, and Mime Jr. always reminds me of Krusty the Clown. It doesn't work for Mr. Mime. But he always reminds me of Krusty the Clown. So we're going to have Krusty. Krusty the Mime Jr. Can I please put a rappel up now? I kind of want to see if I can get to Celestial Tower. And if you can get an encounter up there. I'll do these battles another time. But this is going to be a battle, isn't it? Rich kid Antoinette has a Tangler. I do need to battle all of the trainers in this area. Because I am quite... Well, I'm sort of on par with levels. I feel like... Because Clay had a level 31, I believe. And... We've gone through a cave in that. So I'm expecting Skylar to have like a 35. Which we would be dreadfully under level for. But at the same time... Being under leveled is fine. We can handle being under leveled. A Castilia Cone. Hello. What's going on here? Pokemon moves Mega Drain and Giga Drain. Oh. We trade Boldore for my Emolga. I wouldn't do that. Anyway. But. Oh, is it not? Oh, you walk along it. Oh. Oh. Triple battles. That's a bit scary. That's a bit scary. Swimmer Marilyn. Muk, Altaria, and Cherubi. All level 32. All level 32. I'm not quite sure what to do, to be honest. I think I'm going to take out that Cherubi. Just, like, kill it. Kill it dead. Now I think I'll double into the Altaria slot. Or is Muk a bigger problem? No, Altaria is probably a bigger problem.
Can I reach over there? I can. I thought you couldn't reach over there. If I'd have known that, I wouldn't have used Psybeam on that Cherubi. Oh, I got rid of my Sturdy. Thundershock is actually my strongest move. I genuinely didn't know that you could do that. I thought you had to attack, like, one in. If you were on the outside. Why are you ganging up on Martha? What's Martha done to you? Okay. Oh, you see, no, it must just be fly then. So we gotta do that. And then we'll strength the muck. And then we'll switch Vullaby. We'll switch out Martha. Some good experience for everybody. I say don't get another poison on me. I can't do anything. I genuinely can't do anything. Not that it really matters, because faith should kill. Not quite, but Leviathan will finish off. That's fine. And wants to learn Defog. I'm okay, thanks. Useful in competitive, not so good in the realms of in-game meta. Oh, jumped off the edge. Deep sea scale. If I get a clam pearl, that's useful. Celestial tower. Right. Can you get an encounter in Celestial tower? I realize I'm running over a little bit here. I need to run off this repel. Repel's effect wore off. Can you get anything? Or is it like you gotta go up? Upper floor, perhaps. I was about to say, if you can't encounter something in here, then... Oh. Do I already have anything like this? I don't. I'm kidding myself. I don't even think that this can live in a tap. I don't. But I'm going to attack it anyway. No. Critical hit. I think it would have lived that Psybeam if it hadn't been for that crit. But, alas, this is how the Pokemon world goes. And it was only a Beautifly, so. Not as though I've missed out on anything in particular. I'm just going to fly back to Mistralton because... I can. And then in the next episode, we will take on those trainers going up there and head through all of Celestial Tower and all of that. Actually battle those trainers, because we do need to. We need those levels. So, with that, guys, I hope you have enjoyed this episode of the Pokemon White Randomizer Nuzlocke. If you have,
please do leave a like, comment, and subscription down below. You know that I appreciate all of your interaction. With that, we are going to leave off here. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and I will see you next time. Stay brave, guys.